there is a very sad, heartbreaking, and very disgusting, you know, video that went viral, at least in Uganda, about this sister who works in a nursing home for the old people. Now, she's doing the dishes, and then this lady that she takes care of, this obviously she's a white supremacist lady, she's very racist. She comes close to her and eats repeatedly and repeatedly spits in the face of our sister. Now, the video is going to follow in this clip, but I just want to say this. We don't hate white people. In fact, Africans do not have a history of racism, segregation. We don't have any history of ill-treating people from a different culture. In fact, we have a historic record of being the people that have been so welcoming to Europeans, to Arabs, to people from the Americas, to Asians. And for this reason, our continent fell. Because we let them in, you know, because generally we are a people that loves. We love warmly, we love genuinely. And this is what, you know, took us into slavery and colonialism, because we are people that love. We don't segregate. We welcome you, we give you the opportunities, and this is why we've been exploited to this very day. Now, you'll watch the video, and I'm posting this because I just want us to know, you on the continent and you in the diaspora, that unless we come together and collectively address these kinds of ill treatment of African people, regardless of which part of the world that you are, we will continue being the subject of shame, of embarrassment, of scorn. We will keep at the bottom of the food chain, at the bottom of the hierarchy. We have to come together. And because these people are leaving Africa to go to Europe, to go to the Middle East, to go to the Americas, to look for money in search of greener pastures, as they say. Yet they are leaving the greener pastures here. But then we have not conditioned our people to appreciate and understand the wealth, the pool of wealth that we've got on the continent. And because the white people have discovered it, they're exploiting it and building their kingdoms. In fact, I always tell people, the glory that we see in Europe and in the Americas was solely built on the blood, sweat, and tears of our ancestors, on the resources of our continent, our motherland. They've taken our resources, the people, the land, and the minerals, and they've built their kingdoms. They have made their countries look like the promised land. Yet, it is we that have built all the glory that our sons and daughters on the continent leave and go to search allegedly for greener pastures. This is the solution. We need to come together and begin to build. And this is why I'm always telling people, let's begin to partner. And I thank God, thank goodness, there are people that we are already working with in terms of partnership to address such things. But we're just a small number of people. There is strength in numbers. There is strength in numbers. Anyway, this is the message that I will keep preaching until it actually manifests. And I always tell people, and I'm going to say it again today, in my lifetime, I will see the African continent, the global African sons and daughters unite as one force. I will see that in my lifetime before I die. And I'm giving my all to make sure that this message gets out there. I know it will eventually take root in the hearts of those that are listening. Here's the video of that old lady eating and repeatedly spitting in the face of our sister. Watch, but I have to tell you, these images disturb me, and I'm sure they will disturb some of you, but then we have to expose this kind of stupidity that the white people are throwing in our faces, whatever white means, you know. Anyway, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and like and share. And also, thank you for those that are supporting us on Patreon, that are donating. We very much appreciate your support. And with your donations, we are putting together several things on the continent, doing very, you know, various back-to-back continental crusades, you know, preaching the message of the return of our brothers and sisters. So we have to prepare the hearts of our brothers on the continent and sisters, because we have been so miseducated about our brothers and sisters in the diaspora. That is why there is a mutual misunderstanding and, you know, sort of suspicion between us, though we are one person. But we've been so brainwashed and miseducated by, you know, the Western media into thinking that, you know, this is a group of different group of people on the continent, and the Africans in the diaspora are a different group. So our continental crusades are meant, are geared towards, you know, breaking that yoke, you know, and psychologically preparing our continental brothers and sisters for the return, or the at least visiting of, you know, of our distant brothers and sisters. So if you would like to donate, there is a, towards the end of this video there will be a short illustration. Go ahead and send your support, and we will greatly appreciate. Thank you for watching, and let us know what you think in the comment section. See you next time.
One more.